we would like to enjoy the game by applauding for the players. You are in the middle of the ground. A beautiful straight drive from Sachin goes past, or a beautiful cover drive from Rahul Dravid, you see, but you can't applaud for that. So, I would love to know how, what's your parameters to enjoy the game?
It's a very good question actually, because I'd be lying if I say that I don't feel wow when the straight drive goes like this. But the thing is, it's a very hard thing to control your emotions,
absolutely,
to keep absolutely. A check on them. And over time, we are trained to get the better of the emotions.
Wonderful.
The thing is, when you go onto the ground, if you are emotionally involved in the game, that can be the biggest distraction that you can have. So what we tend to do is, of course, we need to enjoy the game. Of course, we need to enjoy the game in our own way, because it's a profession. And if I don't enjoy, I shouldn't be here. If I have to enjoy the game, what is something that will happen that will make me enjoy? Now, I am an umpire. I am supposed to be a facilitator. Right? Now, I play a backstage role. The game is for the players. Now, what would I enjoy? I would enjoy that the game ran smooth.
Okay.
I played a part in this game being successful. I was there. There were no issues, no player management issues, no match management issues.
Okay.
Which boiled down to the preparation we had again and the teamwork we have on the ground.
Absolutely.
Which will make me enjoy the game. I will not enjoy the game if the game has been scratchy, has been a stop and start stuff, too many things happening, hold ups, players bickering with each other, umpires needing to intervene. Now that is not something I would like to enjoy, because those are the things we are supposed to nip in the bud. Of course, sometimes they get the better of us, because sometimes the emotions of the players will boil on the ground.
Okay.
They play it hard. You can understand that everything will come out. But it's the umpire's job to just draw a line to it. But drawing a line doesn't mean holding a stick like a policeman and just stopping everybody. That's going to stop the game in itself.
That's true.
So rather than facilitating the game, you're going to be a hurdle to the game. So what I tend to look at always is, play a backstage role. Let the players play. The people on the ground are not here to see you umpire. They're here to see the players play.
That's true. That's
and
true.
If you are not in focus, that means you have done a great job.
Okay. So if people don't remember you, it's fantastic.
Yes.
Superb. So you're in the game, but still you are outside the game. People don't notice you. Beautiful. Beautifully said.
Fine.
Facilitator.
It has to be that I am in the game, but people feel that I am playing the backstage role.
Lovely. In Bhagavad Gita, confirmation from Lord Krishna saying that those who are self-realized, they ultimately reach the goal where na karoti cha na lipyate. They do, but they appear that they are not doing. And they are in midst of the emotion, but they are not get attached by the emotion. Actually, the detachment probably that works with you.
Detachment is, I wouldn't say it's the proper word, because if you are detached from the game, I would say you are not emotionally attached. I'll get the word emotion again.
That's fantastic. Okay.
Because if I'm detached from the game, then I'm not in the game.
Okay.
Right. I have to be attached to the game, but I would say emotionally detached. That's the word I would use.